Hey guys, Big Bad Guy here. You all know the stuff. It's getting kind of old. But anyway, here for figure review and taste figure review, as you can see, is the Battle Damage Wolf Predator from Alien vs. Predator Requiem. And before we get into this review, sorry if you hear noise in the background. That's again my crazy family. Nothing I can do about it. And plus there's an enormous storm going on right now. There's tree branches and it's pouring down rain, so not much I can do about that. I'm not God. I can't control the weather. And before I actually get in the figure, let's talk about history. For history, I got this guy, not history, like where he came from, of course. I don't do that. I just talk about where I got it, this figure. I got this figure on eBay for $27 for free shipping. Got for a good deal. It was mint in box. I think that was like one or two years ago, I think. Really good deal. Well, my thoughts on the Alien vs. Predator movie, I hated the first one, the AVP one. I didn't like it. I liked the designs of the Predator, the armor, heavy armor design of them. But I didn't like how the Predator died off so fast. I like Alien vs. Predator Requiem because it seems, you know, it's like the Predator seemed more like a Predator, like it dominated the aliens. Not the aliens dominating not the other way around. So yeah, that was my little rant about Alien vs. Predator. So yeah. First of all, let's get into this review, don't we? So as you can see, it comes with a lot of accessories, so let's get into this. First of all, take this off. Bring lightning. Here's his med pack. No, that's not his med pack. I don't remember what this is in the movie. It's been a while since I've seen it. But as you can see, it's in. You know, it's like, looks like it's been used. They have some nice dry brushing on it. You can't see anything on there. There's no like numbers on it or anything like that. That's a shame. That'd be cool if they added it, but oh well. See the plug. Plugs nice and neat in his back. Like so, pressed in there. Now, whatever, you get the picture. The other accessory he comes with is the med pack, actually. I'm not sure. It's got some really nice dry brushing and detailing on it. Really, really awesome. NECA is always hitting out the park. This is an old figure, too. This is from like 2007. Yeah, also plugs in his back, as you can see. Another accessory right here was the plasma canister. I don't want to take it off because it's really fragile. I don't want to happen to my other one where it broke off. See, it folds in like that and it folds back like that. Really nice. You can take it apart, but I don't want to. That next accessory he comes with is the spear. I want to take it out of his hand because it was a pain and the behind to put it in, so I'm not taking it out. So, you see, it got some nice detailing on it. Got the handle and stuff. Really nice. Like the detailing. And now for the coolest, the main reason I got this, pretty much, because I already had another one, is the facehugger and chestburster. As you see, this has been not in great condition. Got that really gross, disgusting thing right there. Let's get your eyes going. Sorry about that. Yeah. See, even has fingernails. Oh, God. Giving it eebie-jeebies. Just by looking at this thing. It has no eyes. It has a wire in it. Up to this point right here, it has a wire in it. Rest of it's just plastic. Make him face hug someone. Here we got the chest burster. You know, baby alien that burst out of the chest. He's like, bleh. See, really nasty. That's blood on it. Put a zoom in on his face. Just the detailing NECA put on this is just out of this world. It's knocking it right out of the park. Yes, the wire actually broke on mine. So you can actually, in real life, how it's supposed to be. It's supposed to be bendy right there. But yes, I broke it. It's right here. The bed. The broke's right here. Yes, I broke it. Unfortunately. So that's all the accessories. Now let's move on to the figure. Let's get into detailing. Let's give you a nice look at his helmet. Just really, really nice detailing. Got skulls. I like the dry brushing on this thing. It's just fantastic. It's got the traps. This is the battle damage one. So you see the blood and stuff. It's got his blades. It's all the great detail. It's just fantastic. On detailing, I think I'll give it... No, screw it. I'm getting a 5 out of 5. It's just fantastic. It's got his boots. Like, all the dry brushing is just fantastic. It just looks amazing. It's got his boots. It's got spikes on so he can kick you. He's going to stab you. Got more blood right there. As for articulation, he features a ball joint head, so it feels not that much, goes up and down a little bit. It's got pin socket shoulders. They only go up this much, and they go not forward, unfortunately. Well, not on mine. A rotation at the bicep, no bend at the elbow, and a rotation at the wrist. I think ball joints, but it doesn't move up and down, it just moves side to side. He also has his claws, retractable claws. See there, really cool. Same with the other side. His legs, he has a V-cut crotch right there. He's got upper thigh swivel, then at the knee, and swivel at the ankles. Unfortunately, I don't have an alien to put him right next to, so this is some figures I have. So I was pulling up to next his predecessor, the classic 1987 Predator, unmasked. Well, they did size nice to each other. Until he fell, of course. Put him back. And for you Godzilla fans or Kaiju fans, here's the Bandai Creation Big G 2014. And I thought it was good scaling, though Wolf Predator's only like 6 feet tall and Godzilla's like 350 feet tall, so no big deal. So, the set is awesome, comes with a lot of accessories, and has a great sculpt and bad articulation, but, you know, it's a good display piece. Overall, I'll give this set, I give it a 4.5 out of 5. I wish it had more articulation, that's probably the only gripe I have this figure. If it didn't have so much breakabilities, like the other one I broke and I sold it because its head broke off, its plasma canister broke, so I got a new one. So yeah, this is a really long video, Jesus Christ. So yeah, highly recommend this set for any Alien vs. Predator fan or just a Kaiju fan overall. Highly recommend this set. On eBay, they go for a lot. Like, I got mine for $27, now I see them for mint and box color for $60 or $70, like insane. So if you want to get this set, I wish you luck, because it could be a lot of money, it's hard to find. So yeah, hope you guys liked this video. And please rate, comment, subscribe, all that good stuff. Now I'll catch you guys later. Peace.